Hello everyone, I'm CLGTart. I just received a packet from SP Paint to make this one unbox and drawing tips on Medibang app with their new product. This one is called SP Paint Deco Pro size small. You can use it on Android phone, not for iOS. Thank you SP Paint for sending me safe and sound. Now let's me drawing with this tablet. So before starting to do the test with the Android phone, I want to you to make sure that you have to turn the pressure on here. How to turn it on? You can go to the setting and there will be the use pen pressure. Remember to check this on so you will have the pressure on your tablet. Now I will draw a simple artwork with this deco and Medibang. The sketch went real small and the pressure is really great. Unfortunately, they just work on vertical and can rotate. It's uncomfortable for me to hold phone in one hand and drawing in the other hand, so you can see that how I set up is with my custom table. Also, the wheel ring won't work on the phone, or maybe it's still not find out how to make it work on phone. It's work perfectly on computer as expected. I don't know why the hover of the pen cursor move kinda slower than the computer. So sometimes I got stuck with a weird feeling because it have delay response, but actually they are respond right time. This is the first time I drawing a final pic on phone, so I keep make mistake about using phone touch screen and the tablet. When you want to move or touch something with your finger, remember to put your pen out of the drawing tablet area or it won't respond to your finger. I create new layer for painting the base color. To paint the base color on Medibang, the quickest pen for using is fill pen. You can download it on Medibang cloud. You don't need a lasso tool or bucket tool anymore for base color. Just simply draw around the area you want to fill color and this brush will do its job like magic, as you can see on the screen right now. In the middle of my work, I've changed my sketch because I think the hat looks not good. After I fill the base color with fill tool, I will use the pen or G-pen to paint basic shadow self on the face. And now I will show you a little trick with lasso tool and airbrush. Here I will use the lasso tool. You can see that I pick on the menu and draw the place where the light will appear on the face. Then I will go to the airbrush, choose this one, increase the size to 300, the biggest size we have, and choose the light color of the skin. Then I will pan slightly around the place with the selection area like this. You can see that I create the light area on the skin really perfectly. The same for the nose here. How to do the trick like this and make it look perfect, you must have a knowledge about the place where it have the light and place where that the light cannot reach on the face. After done with this, you click deselect and here that we have in the result. Now I'll go with the watercolor wet for nice blending. You can change the setting a little bit, changing the opacity, the size, and remember to pick the nearest color at the place you will paint. That will help you to create the blending feeling, because actually on Medibang you won't have a blend tool, but you will use the trick like this. For some place I want to have a soft feeling, I will pick the airbrush for the best result. So that's all about my trick that you will use the lasso tool for some specific area, the watercolor wet for blending and drawing, airbrush for making soft skin, and that's it. This is how I work in my painting. Thank you. When you paint a picture, the color sometimes may not fit what you imagine, so here's the tips how to change the color in Medibang Paint Pro. Go to the layer, select the layer you want to change the color, and then choose Hue, Shadow Rotation and Brightness. Click that and you will see that will have pre-slider, Hue, Shadow Rotation and Brightness. Change it for Hue to change the color, Shadow Rotation and Brightness for the light and shadow, something like that, even for the color, until you're satisfied with the result. After that, click Set, and you can see that the color is changing here. Now go to the layer and choose Duplicate for the layer I just painted. This will be a copy of the layer I just painted, and is it a backup to help me go back whenever I want or when I make a mistake. Now we will paint the accessory. I will choose the Fill Brush again for the base color of the accessory. Use eye picker to pick the color you want, then create a new layer because I don't want the accessory will make a mess with the original later. Now with the fill tool, you already know how to work, right? Draw the border outside and then it will automatically fill inside for you. For some drawing you need perfect line, you can use the snap as I'm doing right now. I will use the circle snap to make the accessory on the hair of the girl. Like this, you can hold the 3 white circle here to change the size of the circle inside, and you hold the red square to move it around to the place you want it to be. Now I will use Lasso Tool to make a selection area, then use Gradient Tool to make shadow of the accessories. Remember to check the option color transparent when you do this step, or you have to go inside the color wheel to pick background color and make this step more complex. If you're not using the selection area, when you use the gradient tool, the whole picture will be painted with the gradient color. And more than that, for the accessory layer, you should tick the protect alpha, so when you drag the gradient tool, it will just paint in the area where you feel the color. Next, we'll use same trick when we paint the skin, that using selection area and the airbrush to paint the detail of the accessory. The picture will be empty without background, so I decide we'll draw something, create new color layer, use fill brush and pick green color to draw some leaf here at the front and even for some behind. And the biggest trick we will have here that I will create two layer actually, one in the front and one in the back. That will help me to create the depth when you're changing the color of the back and the front. So here I will go in to change the color of the back layer. That's it. You can see that separate layer will help you work better when you want to change some part and the other will stay the same. Next, I will create new color layer above the behind background layer and choose clipping. With this one, I will use the gradient tool and drag some color here to make the shadow of the behind background, and you can see that the depth we're making here. You can go to the hue, shadow rotation, brightness again to change it into the color that fits your eyes. Around more than 4 hours was spent, and here's our final result. Let's create a new layer to make some effect for this picture. Tap here to create a new layer and choose color layer. Okay, I'll go back in here and choose the airbrush. Then I will pick the light cyan color to paint around the eyes. Let's zoom in to the eye to draw it, paint it carefully and real slightly. Remember to reduce the size of your brush to fit the eye so it won't make a mess later. Okay, I will zoom it in and pan around the eye. Remember, don't push it too hard, just slightly. It looks great, right? But it's not really what I expected. It's okay, I will make it look stunning later. Now, I will go back to the layer and click to the blending to make the magic. Click here, edit, and choose add. Then you can see the result, the eyes is glowing. Set. When you feel okay, go back and check it. And then we will do the same for the accessory with the airbrush. And that's it for this tutorial and unbox video. I'm CLGTart, thank you for watching and see you in the future.